you don't play bagpipes. Shut your gob. Sad to say there are a few but few.
To Hart House next for the 75th annual Skule Night. That's S-K-U-L-E. Clever. This is the U of T Engineering Department's yearly chance to show off their performing skills and avoid valuable study time. Cha-cha-cha. And opening tonight at the Factory Theater.
Themselves Max are engaged in a bitter rivalry with a group of computer engineers calling themselves Comps. The stakes, school supremacy, the battlefield, U of T campus. Gah! We were happy with that until the stupid star-crossed lovers showed up. Damn them and their darn star-crossedness. This is their story.
Anything for you, my love. reservation system for it anyway, huh? And look at you! You're leaning on the solar panels!
Hey, man, I'm just working on my tan.
Yeah, I guess we can call it a day. Gino, you done working on the accelerator?
Accelerator? I don't even know it!
You clapping, Mike?
Yeah, I guess so.
Alright, listen up, Mr. Incompetent. Don't mess with anything in the car while we're gone.
Yeah, Jess is coming down to keep an eye on it. Anything happens to that car, you'll be flossing Nike boot out of your teeth for a week.
Bye, Tony.
Alright, let's see what we got here. Wonder if they got the horn hooked up yet.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I'm working on the voice activation system for the car. What are you doing here?
I'm guarding it.
Wait a minute. That means you're Jesse? Matt?
Yeah. Which means you're a comp.
Oh, comps. Max, what does it matter? I see you.
You know, I feel really strongly about this. Like, you know how some people after they kiss, they can't think of anything to say? I'm glad that's not happening with us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you wanna test out the suspension in the car?
Okay.
Such a turn on! Never thought you would be so forward.
Gino! Hey, it wasn't me that left the car in here. That comp screw with anything in it?
Look, Tony wouldn't deliberately sabotage the car. He's put as much work into it as we have.
Yeah, well, look what I found. This has got Tony written all over it.
What is it?
His ID.
That's it. When I get my hands on that comp, I gotta twist him up so bad.
Yes, we wouldn't want this pass guard to the computer lab to fall into the wrong hands, would we?
You could get into a lot of trouble for breaking into the computer lab!
What, Jesse? Are you defending the cops after they did to our car?
Yeah, Jesse, I don't like the idea that my girls want to become.
I am not, was not, and never will be your girl. And I'm a mess through and through, which is why I would never go out with a wannabe ensign like you.
Thank you.
A solar-powered car is a car that runs off the energy from the sunlight, or from a flashlight, or hey, even from a cigarette lighter.
How illuminating.
So what you're telling me is, you missed our next trick tournament to hang out with a bunch of lousy nets.
Well, come on, Jim, don't you think this childish rivalry has gone on long enough?
Yeah, whatever.
I mean, what's a solar-powered car got to do with us cubs? I mean, if it was a solar-powered computer...
Our solar-powered lamp!
Weirdo. Hey, look, an incredible thing happened to me last night.
Hey, you guys take off. Okay, I gotta talk to Tony for a second. See you later. What's up, Tony?
Yeah, like I was saying, the most incredible thing happened to me last night.
Oh, I'll bet. www.playboy.com, eh?
I met a girl.
Oh, yeah? What's her name?
Jessie.
Jessie's a Mac.
I see only her.
Oh. Well, what's she doing right now?
Bouncing on a trampoline.
Oh, yeah.
I gotta go. I got a TA lab in a few minutes. I'll see you later.
All right, later.
No, baby, no.
That's good, Mama.
Hey, what are you guys doing?
What do you think we're doing? We're playing Doom.
Don't we have an exam on Monday?
Exactly.
Cool, I'm in.
All right. What the hell do you kids think you're doing?
Why, if it isn't Professor Krupke.
Afternoon, Professor Krupke!
Knock it off! Thought I told you punks not to play games in here! These computers are for academic purposes only!
This is academics, Pops! I think Doom is the only way to describe my academic career!
You kids, you're never gonna get jobs! You're gonna be worthless all your stinking lives!
Now that's not very nice, Professor! Aren't you supposed to give us a warm learning environment so that we can grow to be valuable members of society?
The day you kids become valuable members of this society is the day Pritchett comes back to finish his engineering degree.
Hey, I thought I told you not to play games in here anymore.
You're gonna be worthless all your life. You need to get a job.
Yeah, get a haircut.
Gee, Professor Krupke, I don't know what to say.
You better start explaining yourself.
Dear kind Professor Krupke, you gotta understand, well, it's just our brilliant upkeep that gets us out of hand. Our mothers are all metrics, our fathers are all chumps. Golly, moves, naturally we're clumps.
Gee, Professor Krupke, we're very upset. We never got to validate while searching the net.
Charles, why can't I find a job? Well, I know I ain't Prince Charles, but still I ain't a slob. My references are flawless, it's just I've never worked. Jeepers, creepers, that's why I'm a jerk.
Come on, Krupke, his fate is not sealed. This boy don't need a D, he needs a job in his field. With the drummer, get out there, he must be distressed. He's just employmently depressed.
Thank you.
situations like this require careful planning. Do we have everything?
Passcard?
Passcard. I guess that's it.
By the time we're done with those sun systems, they'll be replaced with IBMs.
IBMs?
Intensely beaten machines.
Okay, we're in.
Morning, guys. Anybody seen Tony?
No, but hopefully he gets in. He can do something about the mice being busted.
Oh, man, what's wrong with the mice?
Someone stole all the balls.
Hey, speaking of those balls.
Well, if it isn't Mr. Microsoft.
Oh, great. How am I supposed to work on my thesis with these stinking mechs hanging around? Oh, man. Oh, my thesis! Oh, man!
Hey, Jeff, what's wrong?
Somebody erased my thesis. It's gone!
Lying on the floor bawling like sissies.
Hey, who are you calling a sissy?
What, the boot fits?
I can think of a couple of places my boot would fit real good.
Yeah, Tony, that's it. You and me. When I'm done with you, we play scavenger hunt with your body parts.
Yeah, Fernando? Well, I've been looking forward to this for a long time. But just to give you a fair chance, your is Nameless Edison.
For the vandalism and my thesis. You've got a lot of balls, nerdo.
Missing most balls. That's it. No more Mr. Nice, Tony. I am sending you to the dean, and you are going to be expelled. You are in such trouble, mister.
Oh! Hey, cops, anything happens to Bernard, I'm holding you all personally responsible.
Gee, I've never been responsible before.
Anita who?
Jesse, just pay attention, something horrible's happened!
What is it, Anita?
It's Bernardo, he's been...
What? What happened?
Bernardo erased Jeff's thesis and Tony found out from tournament, and now he's been transferred to the Faculty of Arts!
No, Tony would never do such a thing!
It's true, now Bernardo is majoring in modern interpretive neoclassical folk dance.
Tony, right away.
After running into your brother, you're still gonna talk to that intel worshipping booth sector licking geek?
No.
Good.
You are.
What?
Look! They're gonna come down on us hard for this, but you can talk to them. You're an indie. You're not really a mech. Monitor.
I want to sit around and wait for it. You know the mechs are going to come down on us hard for this. I say we get them first.
Yeah, like preemptive like.
Yeah.
Well, actually, the concept of a preemptive strike hardly applies in this case. First, we have done nothing to merit retribution, and paradoxically,
weirdo.
Look, we need Tony. He ain't one of us no more. Those dirty...
Hold your chat section. Tony's got more comp in his calculator than you've got in your old crummy laptop. He's a comp to the core.
Yeah. But his core got dumped 2 years ago. What do we do, Jeff?
We sit tight till Tony gets here, then we'll decide.
Hey, look who it is. It's Anita.
I'm here to see Tony.
Everybody wants Tony today.
So what's your business with Tony?
My business with Tony is no business of yours.
Well, if you're gonna be that way about it, Tony ain't here.
But I can see him over behind the counter sweeping the floor.
Well, that notwithstanding, Tony still ain't here.
Listen, I've got a message for Tony.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, well, what's it all about, huh? Come on, get out. Come on.
Get out, AI. Here's the message. Jessie has decided to plead guilty. She can no longer stay in a school full of ignorant juvenile cavern dorms. Gino's driving her to Ryerson.
She's going to Ryerson to escape ignorance and stupidity?
Saying before she,
I don't know.
need to worry about them. They're cut off.
But hey, two less people means more beer for us.
Canadians have come to expect nothing less! Well, we're ready to begin.
The following match is a
Pissing me off.
It costs nothing.
So I'm gonna give you 17 cents, which is 15% of the price of this beverage, which costs nothing.
Yes.
Well, you're wrong. You know what? You can keep that Coke. I'm gonna take my great tap thing back, and I'm never shopping here again. I'm telling all my friends to do the same. Between the six of us, you're going down.
Ha! Come back from that one.
Have a nice day.
Yeah!
Fuck you!
bank card to the machine, wouldn't give me any money. What's up with that?
Well, if you just hand over your bank card, I'll pull up your transaction record on the computer, and we'll see what the problem is. Oh, now there you go. Your account is overdrawn.
Overdrawn? But I opened that account with $3,000!
Well, there are a few charges associated with those.
What? Cost of entering new account computer, $3. Cost of replacement ink for pen used by new client, $12. National administrative fees, bank administrative fees, kitchen utensils.
That's a new toaster we gave.
Total charges incurred upon opening a new account, $3,000.
Oh, now that can't be right. Let me see. Oh, now you see the final line should actually read $3,112.
Let me get this straight. I opened an account here yesterday, gave you $3,000, and today I owe you $112? What the hell kind of bank is this?
A very profitable one.
The Royal Bank of Montreal, where your ass is our asset.
Chicken?
No, I'm just trying to explain the joke to you. Well, yeah, we'll talk about it later. Gotta cuss.
why you want to enter our beloved United States of America?
I have business there.
Please state exactly what you'll be doing there.
I will exactly be doing some consulting there.
You know, ma'am, with a tongue that sharp, I'm surprised you haven't put Ginsu out of business. Let's try that again. Please state exactly what you'll be doing there.
I'll be working for the United States Postal Service.
And you work for who?
I work for Computer Consultants of Canada.
Are they Canadian?
Yes.
Are you Canadian?
Yes. Eh?
All right, let me get this straight. You're Canadian, working for a Canadian company, you know, so for an American company, now is that right?
Yes.
No, why?
Excuse me?
To what? I. You speak American, don't you?
Yes.
So why would an American government call Canadian down to do work that a good old American boy could do?
Because your government hired me.
They hired you?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, you have proof?
Yes, I have.
Okay, great. Now, get all the way.
Bagged me a 180-pounder. One less Canadian in the world.
So much for standing on guard for thee.
And what are you looking at?
Nothing.
Hey, Mr. Johnson, I heard a joke. Why did chicken cross the road?
I don't know, Billy, why?
To get to the other side. Well, I didn't get either. All right, Mr. Johnson, you're set. Off you go.
Carrying a corpse!
Well, you mean a cadaver or a dead body? Yeah.
And a rifle!
Of course, for he's a fine, outstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal...
No, well, shut up a second! What if I told you that it was actually a CIA agent returning from a top-secret mission in Canada?
Oh, yeah, Mommy was... Oh. Really?
Yes!
You have any proof?
No!
What are you doing up there?
I could tell you, but then I'd have to kill you. Eh?
Well, you know your paperwork's all set. Off you go. You enjoy your stay in America. You get the Canadians, yeah? And remember, anytime you want to get across the border, just tell the truth. You'll be yourself, or you're a fine, outstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal American person.
And hey, if you're not busy later, maybe we can...
In your dreams!
Hello, Kenny. Come in, have a seat. Please, sit anywhere you like.
Thank you, sir. Hey, there's nowhere to sit.
Yes, I know. Pretty funny, don't you think?
Yes, sir. Very funny, Doctor...
Pretty darn mean!
Ooh, I'm sorry, sir. I wasn't trying to be mean.
No, you imbecile, that's my name! Doctor Pretty Darn Mean! 6 more months of pretty darn mean things, and the Brotherhood upgrades me to downright nasty. 2 months later, I become a full-fledged Dr. Edel! Which comes with a certificate and a swell set of steak knives.
Well, Doctor Pretty Darn Mean...
Please, Kenny, call me Doctor.
Doctor! I have something for you, something that may allow the Brotherhood to look favorably upon you. I have made a great discovery in the world of paleontology.
Mm-hmm. Listen, I have no time for your large words and nonsense. Tell me what I need to know.
Do you see this test tube?
Yes.
Inside it is a real 100% living dinosaur!
Kenny, I'm afraid someone has played you on. Dinosaurs are in fact huge creatures that wreaked havoc upon the world millions of years ago. They had huge pointy teeth and purple skin and could often be seen coaxing children into singing asinine songs. Simply put, you can't fit a dinosaur into a tube.
That's where you're wrong, Doctor. I've cloned dinosaurs from fossils. However, I realized early on that dinosaurs running around the lab are just too dangerous. So I devised a formula that would make these dinosaurs microscopic as long as they remain inside this test tube.
What happens if you break the tube?
Oh, another failsafe. It won't grow unless it gets wet. Kind of like sea monkeys.
I like those!
Yes, so you see, they're perfectly safe to carry around.
I still don't see what this has to do with me.
Well, I was thinking you could use these dinosaurs for one of your evil plans.
Oh?
Oh, yes!
That's a good idea.
And I only ask a small fee be deposited in my Swiss bank account.
Money is no object. It'll be done. When can we put the me in customer?
Well, I can give you the test tube right now if you'd like.
Oh no. I think it makes far more sense to travel some obscene distance. Somewhere where I can build a huge underground base with little regard to plausibility, zoning laws, or union rules. What we need is a desert island. An uncharted one, preferably. Actuate the map.
How about this one?
Ideal. Should only take about 3 hours to get there by boat tour. There'll be no one to stop us this time. No!
Kitchen over that quicksand pit.
Now, Skipper, it's not all that bad.
I lose 7 square meals a day.
Yes, but remember the garbage disposal possibilities. You couldn't get faster removal anywhere else.
Quite right. We don't have to pay a salary either. Isn't that right, Lemmy?
What?
We work it out, Professor.
Well, I'm trying to build us another radio so we can call for help and get off the sun. But damn it, bamboo just isn't a very good semiconductor.
Well, Professor, perhaps you aren't doping it properly. We're still going to need coconuts if I'm going to make a casserole. Gilligan, can you go and get me a dozen?
Sure, Marianne, no problem. Hey, I think I see a boat.
What?
Where?
Oh my God!
A boat! I think it's just a dinghy.
Who cares? We're going to be rescued! Hey. Yay!
Can you make anything else out?
There's no man on the boat, and he's coming this way!
Well, I've got to get started.
Doing what?
We have to throw a welcoming party. What will he think of us?
Oh, there's one man in the boat, and he's walking this way!
Well, that's an awfully funny way to walk.
Who cares? We're going to be rescued!
Yay! Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, who are all of you people? Do you work for the doctor?
Who? Doctor who?
No. Pretty darn mean!
Hey, don't insult Gilligan.
No. I work for a doctor pretty darn mean.
Well, who cares? We're gonna be rescued!
My God! You idiot! It's broken! Do you realize what you've done?
Of course I do. What did I do?
Is there something valuable in there?
Diamonds, perhaps.
No, you idiot! That was a dinosaur embryo! I was going to meet Dr. Pretty Darn Mean and sell it to him to help him in one of his world domination schemes! Oh, get into the hut!
Is that Dr. Pretty Darn Mean, you said?
Yes!
Is he listed on the stock exchange?
Yeah! Why?
Bloody good, I'm going to buy some of his stock. World domination is always good for the market.
Mr. Howe, you mean to say you've had a laptop here this entire time and never once used it to call for help?
Quite right, my boy. Tax reasons. It's for business purposes only.
You're all insane! If that dinosaur gets loose, it will destroy us all!
Oops. Skipper, quickly! Where did it land?
On the beach by the minnow!
Hey, has anyone noticed the minnow seems a lot smaller these days?
Oh, that's because it's only 9/10 scale.
Can you see the dinosaur?
Nope.
Oh, that's because I've added certain safety features, you see? That dino is almost totally dehydrated, so it won't grow unless it gets wet.
Oh, look at the little
That really didn't seem to grow too big.
That's because of my second safety feature. You see, it now requires heat energy to trigger the enzymes that will cause it to rapidly grow to full size. However, without my special machinery, it would take something about as hot as molten lava for it to grow to full size.
Come on, everybody, let's go.
Quick, everyone! We gotta get that boat and get off this island!
We can't leave yet, we haven't had a going away party! And why don't we invite the dinosaur to eat while we're at it?
We're gonna need supplies! Gilligan, can you go to the supply hut and get me some coconuts? I'm gonna make a casserole!
Not more coconuts! Can we ever eat McDonald's?
Sure, Mariette.
Don't forget my diamonds.
And my laptop.
And my microscope.
And my beer.
Well, I have everything I need.
Come on, Gilligan, my buddy. Hurry up.
You know, this reminds me of a movie I was once in. The evil island of Gamera, the fiery turtle. There was once this lost island of primitive people who worshipped this dinosaur-like turtle. I play the part of the beautiful reporter who was captured by this tribe.
Oh! Can't we just sacrifice her to the volcano or something?
Gilligan!
I'm coming!
Well, all evil geniuses have an alternate plan, and so do I. Perhaps you recognize this?
It appears to be an analog radio communication device to connect a mobile user to a landline by utilizing multiple antenna sites, operating the 800 megahertz range as opposed to the newer digital devices.
Yes! It's a cell phone! And I'm going to use it to call my boat. I have a transmitter there that you see that will attract the Tyrannosaurus onto the boat, and then it will sail away to New York and off to world domination!
You do know that dinosaurs can't swim.
Don't! You just enjoy poking holes in my plan!
Why, Professor? You're hurting his feelings.
Yes! Well, we'll soon see who's right. Yes, hello. Turn on the transmitter. Hey, come on. No, the switch is on the left. Good. What? No, carrots and celery, only the base of the soup. Fine, I'll bring coconuts then. Same to you. There, that's done. Go to the boat and make the preparations for world domination. And take Hobson the cat with you. Ah, yes. And now for the overly complex death.
No, not more coconuts!
No, not more coconuts. As you may have already noted, my friend Kenny here is sporting a brand new bomb! It has precisely 3 minutes left on the timer, which is just enough time for me to watch half of this evil Mike Harris commercial.
Hello!
sell you my jewelry.
Jewelry's my passion!
Yeah. Hey, some of this may be a bit on the warm side. How much do you think this is worth?
I say about 10 to 20 years, you foul criminal! God, take him away! Ooh! At Oliver Jewelry, I inspect all jewels against the police database to ensure that I do not give cash for stolen jewelry. Stolen jewelry is certainly not my passion. Oh, another customer. It's my good friend, Mega Mayor Mel Lastman.
Hey, Russell, how's business?
Great. Anybody complaining in the mayor's office?
Nobody. Hey, Russell, you still paying top dollar for used jewelry?
Used jewelry is my passion.
That's great. Besides that, all cities, except for North York, of course, to give me all their used jewelry so we can help fight the deficit.
I'd be glad to help. Just leave me the jewels and take my cash.
Hey, with all this extra money I got from Russell Oliver, I can afford that house in Muskoka and new Mercedes I've always wanted. Thanks, Russell.
Satisfaction guaranteed. Here comes another customer right now. This one's a real sucker if I've ever seen one. Hello!
I want to stand face to face with a 400-year-old redwood and then chop it down!
and with my favorite semi-automatic machine gun by my side, I sing, sing, sing.
For Christ's sake, Julian, please sit down. You gotta stop freaking out like that. That's the third time this week. I mean, sure, it was cute the first time, but you gotta get a hold of yourself. You're a data enterer. You entered data. You gotta get out of the bump and grind. You gotta get out of your Rambo lumberjack fantasies and get into the bump and grind of your white collar life. Burn up my necktie and set myself free. Cause no one's gonna fold, bend, and mutilate me. And it's old boys, can't you code it? The program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling out the data on the Xerox line. And it's old boys, can't you code it? And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine.
Well, I bet you'll even have a good use for the money.
Of course I do. I'm using the money for a sex change.
exchange reversal too. I used to be a blonde for Mississauga. But my husband left me. Turns out he was gay. So I had a sex change to be able to seduce him, but I never saw him again. So I figure it's time to go back to the way I was meant to be. A sexy, sultry woman.
Mississauga. But I left her and had a sex change because I thought I was gay. But I'm not. I was wrong. So now I want to be a man again so I can find her.
Hold on a second.
Public service announcement for anyone over the age of 40. Life in the 50s.
Yeah, I'll have a pack of cigarettes
and a box of condoms.
Life in the 90s.
Yeah, I'll have a box of condoms and
a pack of cigarettes.
Yeah.
today with the amazing new H2O. Yes, H2O removes even the toughest water and club soda stains from any scotch guard.
What about this dirty plate?
Just rinse with H2O, and that spaghetti sauce will fade away in seconds. And that's not all. Look what happens when I pour clear nail polish all over this vinyl tabletop. And then wipe with H2O.
I spilled blood and grab and motor oil all over the shirt. With the money I saved buying H2O, I bought this new shirt.
H2O will take care of all your cleaning needs. Developed by top researchers at McMaster University. It's completely non-toxic and entirely biodegradable. And if you order right now, we'll give you this second smaller bottle at no extra charge. And if you promise to tell just one friend so we can get some word of mouth advertising, we'll throw in this free applicator!
H2O brought to you by the makers of Fire, Earth, and Air.
Time. forthrightly.
Without a leader, the revolution was crushed, and the people found themselves once again under the tyranny of English rule.
50 years.
But monsieur, it is the same.
No, excuses, the law clearly states wherever the French sign is also the English sign.
Okay.
No, the English sign must be above the French sign.
Whatever you say.
Much better. I'll let you have the wine this time, but don't let me get your violet and lime claws again.
Oh, ça c'est horrible. Tell me, mon ami, why do you have the English signs? Why do you do what the English say?
What, the English have been in charge since the last attempted revolution? Where have you been for the last 50 years?
Hanging around the bars, mostly.
Wait, do you hear something? Who is there? Who calls?
A friend.
And what did you have for dinner?
French fries with gravy and cheese curds.
Poutine!
Revolution!